In this video, we will show you how to install and configure the IKAN ALM solution phases for ODI. The LCM solution includes two dedicated phases. One to execute the build process. This phase will retrieve the objects or scenarios out of the VCR and put them in an archive for further deployment use. The second one to deploy the archive, namely the objects or scenarios, to an ODI repository. For an easy setup of the phases, it's recommended to collect the following information: the ODI home location, the username and passwords for ODI and the master repository, the ODI work repositories, and the SIDs of the master repositories. Parameters can be defined on phase, environment, or machine level. The phase parameter takes precedence over the environment parameter, which in turn takes precedence over the machine parameter. There is no general rule to determine on which level you should define the parameters. It depends on your company standards, on how unique the parameter is, whether it's used in only one phase or in several phases, on how unique the parameter value is. For example, if the value is the same for all environments, you probably want to define it globally on the phase level. If the value is different for each environment, you could specify the value on environment level. If the value is the same for all levels and all environments on a machine, it might be interesting to define the parameter on machine level. The installation and implementation of the ODI solution phases is done in a few simple steps. First, you import the phases in the IKAN ALM interface and specify the global parameter values in the global administration section. Next, you add the phases to the different environments, and if required, you adjust the environment parameters. Let's start with the installation of the phases. We recommend you to organize your folders in the following way. Create an ALM data folder at the same level as the IKAN ALM home folder. And in that folder, you create the subfolder env. Next, you copy the solution phases subfolder from the temporary location where you unzip the file to the ALM data folder. When that's done, you are ready to start the installation of the phases. First of all, you need to import the ODI solution phases in IKAN ALM. Phases are imported in the Global Administration section. On the submenu, you can select Phases, Import, or you can click the Import link on the Phases subpanel. Use the Select File button to select the phase you want to import. Browse to the location where you copied the solution phases. Select the required phase and click the Open button. As a result, the Import Phase screen will display the information concerning the phase, the files it contains, and the phase parameters. Next, click the Import button to confirm the action. You must repeat this procedure for each of the phases you want to use. The two phases we imported are now displayed on the Phases overview. As said before, phases can be defined on phase, machine, or environment level. In this demo, we will keep the definition of the parameters as simple as possible. You can find an in-depth explanation of the different ways of defining parameters in the IKAN ALM user guide. If you need advice on a particular situation, you can always contact the IKAN ALM support team. Let's continue. We have imported the phases, and next we need to verify and, if needed, modify the default values of the phase parameters. Here you see an overview of the different parameters you most likely will need to modify in the Global Administration section. The parameters are set to mandatory by default. In this context, mandatory means that the parameters will be automatically created when adding the phase to a level or build or deploy environment. Let's first add the correct values for these global phase parameters. On the Phases overview, you click the pencil icon in front of the phase you want to edit. Underneath the Phase Info panel, you will find the list of all defined phase parameters. This list can be sorted alphabetically by clicking the column header. We want to edit the ODI Home parameter, so we click the Edit icon in front of it. This will open the Edit Phase Parameter window. Specify the value and click Save. This procedure must be repeated for each of the mandatory parameters. To specify the hosts and ports for the ODI master and work repositories, we use the Oracle default values. Obviously, if your value is the same as this default value, no modification will be required. If not, you will also have to make those parameters mandatory and modify their default value. We are now ready to add the solution phases to our build and deploy environments. This must be done in the project administration section. Select your project from the overview. Display the build environments overview and click the Edit Phases icon. This will show a list of the default IKAN ALM phases. We now want to remove some of those phases and replace them with the ODI-specific solution phases. In this example, we need to remove the Verify Build script, Execute scripts, and Transport Deploy script phases. When done, we will insert the Copy ODI Files phase. To do so, click the Insert Phase link. Select the phase that must be inserted, specify its position and the next phase on error, and click the Insert button. On the Phases overview, the Copy ODI Files phase is now added to the overview. Now let's do the same for the deploy environments. First, we display the deploy environments overview. In this case, we only need to delete the Verify Deploy script and Execute script phases. Next, we want to add the Restore Oracle DI Objects phase after the Decompress Build Result phase. We have three deploy environments: Test, Acceptance, and Production. All actions need to be repeated for the three environments. At the beginning of this demo, we already have modified the default values for the mandatory parameters. Also for the deploy environments, some parameters need to be modified. The default value of the ODI.action parameter is set to restore all objects. This is correct for the test environment, but for the acceptance and production environments, this value must be modified to restore all scenarios. On the deploy environment overview, select the Edit Phases icon and next the View Parameters icon for the phase you want to edit. All parameters have now been set. We are ready to start our build process. As the level in IKAN ALM is still locked, we first need to verify that all definitions are consistent. To do so, we select Audit Project on the submenu. On the overview, you will see most of the objects we have created. The overview also displays the build archive of the head project stream where the future builds will be stored and the build level containing the build environment on the IKAN ALM agent. Click the Unlock button and we are ready to build. All components of the LCM for ODI solution are now installed and configured. Next, continue to the Build and Deploy movie to see our solution in action. For more information on our company and products, we invite you to visit our website. Thank you for watching.